Hey guys, this is Andre from the Trading Crew. I'm an entrepreneur, stock enthusiast, and on this channel, I plan on breaking down stocks I love, stocks you love, and most importantly, stocks nobody should. For today's topic, actually, I wanted to break down 5 stocks for you guys, having a look at what exactly is the latest and greatest in terms of recovery stocks. These aren't necessarily reopening centric, although some of them fall really well into that niche. Obviously, if you get anything out of this video, please make sure to subscribe and like it, and I'm gonna continue posting almost every single day, so just stay tuned. Okay, cool. So having a look here, I'm gonna start with AMD first. If you're looking at getting your info and hopping right off, these are the 5 stocks: AMD, Baba, Intel, Disney, and CCL. Cool, so let's have a look at AMD here. AMD has been facing, obviously, the whole tech sellout, but it managed to find support in the $73 range. It had a couple of really good days recently, and obviously today looks like another green day for the Nasdaq market especially. It has a load of upside potential here for a stock like AMD that's included in the Dow Jones Industrial Average. It's a really, really powerful stock. We have around 20% potential upside, so it's a lot given, again, the sheer size of the stock here. So definitely one of my favorites. Next here in line is Baba. I'm sure that you guys know the whole debacle with China penalizing Alibaba and actually fining them a $3 billion fine. That's huge when you think about it. But if you guys just have a look at the number of shares that Alibaba has, they have around $2.71 billion. So actually the per share fine that they received was no bigger than $1.03. So if we have a look here, $1.03 would have definitely been less than 1% for them. But as you guys can see, Alibaba is currently down no less than 35%, which makes it an overreaction. Obviously, it's a huge company, really, really strong fundamentals. Their earnings report just a week ago was absolutely tremendous for a company their size. So this is a huge opportunity here for such a stable stock as Alibaba. Next in line is Intel. Again, same sort of microchip shortage type play. These are definitely bound to have a strong comeback and a strong next year or so. So definitely have Intel on your watch list. It's at an important support area here where it bounced off as well as bounced back from it a couple of times before. So definitely a good place to start investing if you're looking into investing in a solid company like Intel. Disney is the next in line here. Disney recently reported earnings as well as subscriptions for their new streaming, and we've been seeing numbers have slightly underimpressed with their subscriptions. That being said, they just recently started reopening some of the parks, and with Disney being near all-time highs but still a decent pullback from all-time highs, we're seeing a potential profit here of around 20%, which again for a company like Disney is absolutely huge. The next and very last here that we're gonna have a look at is CCL. Obviously, you've been watching the news with the vaccination going well, COVID hopefully becoming a thing of the past here, and with a couple of the cruise ships starting to go towards the vacation spots, Greece and whatnot. CCL is a very powerful player in the market, and prior to the pandemics, it was at $51. So just imagine, guys, investing in CCL now when they're basically at pandemic levels, and then holding for a year, year and a half until they manage to go back into their full stride. It's a whooping 80-90% potential comeback to previous, not all-time highs, just previous highs prior to the pandemic. All-time highs, I believe, are considerably higher at around 150, no, 80 bucks, it seems like. Cool. So if we were to go back to the $80 that their previous high was, just give me a sec here, we'd potentially be looking at an uptick of around 170%. Obviously, that's a bit more optimistic than we should ever think, but there's still a lot of potential value here. And both on the weekly as well as on the daily chart, we can clearly see a sign of support. This line, this blue line here that I drew, it's definitely going to continue going higher and higher. And the potential here with CCL moving out of the pandemic is absolutely huge. So these are my five favorite stocks at the moment. Please don't take it as a solicitation to buy. Do your own research. And if you love any stocks, feel free to drop them in the comment section below. I'll be more than happy to break them down for you. And yeah, just leave a thumbs up if you got anything out of the video. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.